believe I can fly. Wait, we already did this. What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here. Hope you guys are having a good day. Hey, did you guys notice this? Look at this. Does that make any sense to you? Is that even a thing? Look at that. So you can place a lot of entities inside a single block space now. I don't think you could do that in the last version of Feed the Beast. It works with buttons and torches. So pretty cool stuff, pretty cool stuff. But I've been working hard doing stuff and things, and I've been changing up the houseboat. Some people in the comment section of the video last time said, Slip, that's not a boat. You know what, people? The world is your oyster. You can just live your imagination. And this is a houseboat. So anyway, I ended up getting some willow wood. So I found if you just spawn the Natura, the dye trees over and over, they just spawn different types of wood. So there's no sort of like rhyme or reason to it. You get a different type of wood with whatever of the color leaves you're using of the dyed tree sapling. So I did that for a while to get a bunch of willow, and then actually Unhost had a real live willow sapling. I went looking for them for like, I don't know, half an hour, couldn't find one. He had one, so I added a little bit more color. Also, look at this, shrouded silent pressure plates. Pretty sweet. So if you take a look at, did I type that right? Absolutely did not. Oh my gosh. Obsidian. Where are they? Shrouded silent right here. So you need to make the silent pressure plate, pretty easy to do. Then you make the shrouded one. So that's a thing. And I added a bunch of these bibliocraft things in the area as well. So this is the willow desk, and you can put book and quills in here. And then you can, if you see, you can actually change the look, like where they are, and it changes how the books are displayed. I added a bookcase over here. I added that guy over there. Then up in the top, I added some of these willow seats and another desk right over here where the book kind of laid out. So just getting a little bit of that, you know, a little bit of that detail rock. And I added some posts in here. So I thought that stuff and things was pretty cool. Pretty cool stuff and things. I put a spot loader over in this area just to load this machine, make sure it's loaded. I don't want to load too many chunks. Just trying to keep the lags down. I also enchanted all my armor. Oh, let me show you what we got going on over here. Unhost is a Feed the Beast playing robot. I think a body snatcher got him. Because Unhost has just been playing. I don't think he slept last night. It's been pretty crazy. But we've got some Silk Touch, some guys have. And they've moved some of these purple cave crystals into enchanting area. So you can just sit here and get XPs. Cheaty. Super cheaty. Which is the best. But I got, what is it, Protection Unbreaking Aqua Affinity, Unbreaking Protection, Haste 2, Protection Thorn. So just a, you know, a little bit of enchants on the armors. There's a bunch of things I got to update you guys on. Oh yeah, if you didn't know this about Tinker's Tools, the Tinker's Construct pick will, when you right-click it, it selects the last slot in your hotbar. So if you place torches like that, pretty cool stuff. You can't do anything like use a, I was thinking, oh, it would be rad if I could put my hang glider in there and hang glide with the right click, but you can't. You can't do that. And I also made a darkwood bow. I just thought it would be cool to use darkwood and make this in, so I enchanted it and I got power 5 and breaking 3. Pretty rad stuff. So all sorts of cool stuff going on over here at the houseboat. Some other things that I wanted to start getting going. I've been using my luggage as kind of a chest, just for stuff. So I got my regular shovel and, you know, just some other garbage inside of there. But I wanted to get an ender pouch going in case I die. Really important. So I made this ender chest and dyed it. And then I placed it in the wrong place. Completely. So what we're going to do real quick is... Yeah, let's go ahead and grab, well, let's go ahead and do this. So let's grab our ingot cast, and I've made some aluminum brass. So you can see aluminum brass in here, and aluminum brass is 3 parts aluminum, 1 part copper. So then we can take this aluminum brass and get one of these guys, do this, and then we're going to be able to, oh, that's my ender pouch. I have it all ready to go. I'm ready to create the ender pouch. So we can do that right now. So we just create the ender pouch and then shift click. There we go. Now it's linked. So if we stick something inside of here, it's going to be inside of there. All right. Now what we wanted to do is we should have enough to make, I only want to make 4 of these silky cloths. And the silky cloths are going to be used because we're going to make a silk touch pick. So let's get an emerald. And this is how you make the silky gem, I think it's called. Silky jewel. So we need the silky jewel on our new pick. So we have, let me see. We have an iron tough rod. We don't really need that. I gotta take a little time. I think I'm out of obsidian. I'm gonna get obsidian for the reinforcement, or for the unbreaking. Get some obsidian and get some stuff and things together, and then we're gonna make a silk touch tool. Pretty exciting. So we're gonna kinda two birds with one stone here. And what we're gonna do is, through smelting some of the nether, I can't remember which one it was, some of the nether ores that I smelted, I ended up getting some steel ingots. So we're going to use steel on this tool. And so a couple things I want to clear up. Some people were asking me why I would use obsidian. So for the handles for the previous tools that I made. So material tape, reinforce 3. This is unbreaking 3, basically, is what it has on it. So even though the durability this adds is only 71, it adds an unbreaking trait. And then with the repair that I'm putting on these, it's an inexpensive material to use, and I don't need the durability to be higher. These are auto-repairing, so there's no point in having something like... I mean, yeah, it would be great to have 1,200 durability from slime crystals, but don't need it. Not important. So let's go ahead and make another pick. So we're going to use the obsidian tool rod, the paper binding, which adds a modifier, and then we're going to use the steel pickaxe head. So the reason that... Oh, crap, I didn't name it. Crap! I'm an idiot. So I didn't name it. You can only name it once you're making it. But this is Aaron Doral, who is the number 5 Cylon. So let us talk about the modifiers we're going to put on this real quick. So here's 3 of the modifiers that we're going to use. And if we take a look at the tool right now, it has only 4 modifiers available. Let's add a block of gold and a diamond. It's going to add a modifier slot, 5. Let's put repair on it, so then it'll be down to 4. Let's silky this guy. So now we have 3 modifiers remaining. And then the reason that I use steel on it is because right now we're not able to mine. See, alumite is a cobalt level material, as is cobalt and ardite. And you need cobalt level to mine, I think it's, confusing word. These different mining levels. But steel, which is a fairly easy material to get, is the first one in the chain that's going to allow you to mine cobalt. So I think what we're going to do as far as modifiers go. Oh yeah, and we have silky now. So this guy's silk touch. So we could pick up. Oh, are you the slowest thing ever, Aaron Doral? Aaron Doral, thank you. So we can pick up our ender chest. And then we're just going to stick the ender chest back in here. We don't need it to be out and about. The next thing we're going to do is add some modifiers for speed. I think that I don't need luck on it. I don't need anything except haste. So we'll go ahead and get some redstone blocks like so. And I just put in both the redstone blocks and the redstone dust. Because what happens, for instance, see this is at 89, I can do it again, and then see it's at 98. And now it won't let me go to the next level until I put a single, and now I can go to the next level, and now I can do blocks again. Oh wait, I can't? Okay, the next one, there we go. All right, so now I should be able to do blocks again, see? So I just do them both, because it's way faster that way. You don't have to worry about moving them around or anything like that. So I think that we're maxed out on this guy. So silk touch 1, a little bit of haste, not a ton. But, you know, one of the things that having the ender pouch is going to allow us to do, which is pretty rad, let me put this guy away, is we can go ahead and stick some stuff in here. Like, say we're going to go to the nether and say we don't want to worry about losing any of this stuff. Like so. So now we can go into the nether and possibly have a good little adventure and get some stuff and things. Now I'm finding the nether to be, first of all, I guess I did want to say as well, what do you have? What do you give me? What do I have? Fire resistance and speed? Why do I need fire resistance? But I don't know. But thank you, Unhost. Oh. That's kind of cool looking. With the lines back there? I don't know. Anyway. So, oh yeah, Nether. One of the things I wanted to say is that these beginning times, man, when we're just like starting off and you don't have your power armor and you don't have AE and stuff like that, I'm finding it to be like really fun. Like, I don't know. I went to the Nether earlier today and got a bunch. Oh, man. That's scary noise. Let's get the Darkwood bow out. Where are you, man? Where are you, Beholder? So I came into the Nether earlier, and I was harvesting a bunch of stuff and things because these materials are about twice as lucrative. They provide you with about twice as much. Where are you? Let's get this Beholder. I haven't been able to kill one. But the Nether Orbs provide you with about twice as much materials as regular ore does. One more. What do you drop, man? Give me your things. Did you just drop nothing? You are... What a jerk. So, yeah, we get about twice as much from Nether materials. And so when I came in here, like, I needed some lapis because I was building some tools. And just getting the lapis from this area, so much more effective. Now, I'm going to have to re-break all this crap, which kind of stinks. But, whatevs. But I also, while I was in here harvesting some materials... Oh, yeah, I forgot to tell you as well. I put another torch in here, I think, or a magnum torch, I said. Now, I'm pretty sure this works. Oh, yeah, pinky. This works versus pigmen. So I'm pretty sure we're not getting any pigmen spawns or gas spawns in the area. Natural mob spawns are... Oh, really? Are you not aggressive? You're proximity-based aggression? Sweet. So, yeah, I haven't seen any pigmen in the area at all. But I have seen beholders. All the Doom mods are still here. Mobs, I said. So all the Doom mobs we're still getting. But still, it makes it safer. Makes it a little bit safer. But while I was over here, I marked some stuff and things in the area. Let's go ahead and see if I can find them. So I think over... I can't remember where they were. Oh, you want to go with my Darkwood bow? Oh, we can do that. Oh, it's totally cool, man. Oh. So he drops a little ender, a little dust. So I thought I had marked. Oh, this guy is. They're, those guys are still BA. And their fire damage, for some reason, does way more. I don't can't remember what they called. Belfs? Oh, what did you give me, Belf? Thank you, Belf. Doomfire charges can be used to create fires or fired from a dispenser as a Doomfire blast. We got to try it out. So, oh yeah, foods. And I found one that I had marked. So here's a piece of cobalt ore right here. And then we should be able to pick this up with our silky. Yeah. So now we can grab this stuff, which whereas before we just couldn't get it. And then we can use this to make kind of some next level tinker tools. I think... Scary noise. Get away from me. I swear, I think this bow shoots straighter. I'm trying to figure out where I had placed that other... The other torches. I found two other pieces of cobalt. So I think they're over in this direction somewhere. So, anywhoozle, I'm going to mine this cobalt. I'm going to fight some mobs. I'm going to enjoy my time here in the Nether. Which, now that I have some armor and some actual weapons, it's kind of enjoyable. Little experience being around here. Oh, here's some more. So I'm going to enjoy my time in the Nether, and then I'm going to go back into the overworld once we get some, you know, little haul of materials. And I got something else we're going to show you. So we're back at the houseboat, and I forgot to mention something kind of important. You may have noticed these chisel glass panes that I didn't even speak about at the beginning when I was like, oh, I made some changes with these green posts. So I made these chisel glass panes. And they're just using, I just used the chisel. Where is my chisel? So I'm going to pull actually this stuff out of here. This out and that out. I don't really care. We'll leave the other stuff in the luggage. But yeah, I'm going to pull that stuff out and stick it all in my ender pouch. Bam, 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 bam. So, yeah, these are just glass panes using the chisel, and they're really cool. And the reason why I ended up really wanting to put the green in is because when I changed these into this color, I love the look of it, but it took away from the color of the base. It was no white anymore. So that's why we added the green, to make things a little more visually stimulating. So, this is the haul that we got from the Nether. Pretty crazy. I'm just firing up some netherrack bricks in here, but really good for, like, I don't even know, like a half an hour's worth of hanging out there. And now that we actually have some decent armor, not super dangerous. But something else happened, pardon me, last night. I was hanging out with the boys, and we were just kind of doing some stuff and things, hanging around, not recording. We decided that we wanted to go. It was Unhost, Jassassin, and Hypno and I. And we decided that we wanted to go find the end portal. And it was kind of crazy. Like, we were just doing it, and then all of a sudden, everyone was like, we should probably record this.
So I wonder if we throw an item through the portal, will it render like all the end chunks before we go through? Oh, something happened. That's a good question.
I just did. I just threw an item in there. I don't know what happened.
Here's a torch for good luck.
I'll throw a lucky torch too.
They're probably just going right through. No, they went in.
Here's a berry.
We need to make the Ender Dragon steak. Happy.
Steak.
Here you go. Sacrificial cobble. Weird.
So, Jassassin. Oh,
I didn't.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Yeah, that guy.
Oh no.
Oh, he's dead.
Oh crap.
He's dead.
Flips in.
I'm building the thing. I'm building the thing right now.
I've got.
Wait. It has to go on the outside, doesn't it?
Is it safe in there?
Yeah, it's safe. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to go through.
Do you see the Ender Dragon? Is
no,
it like
it's not loaded.
Coming at you, bro?
No, it's not loaded.
Oh, we just got a whole bunch of squid on the mini map. I don't know if you can see that. That's so weird.
No. I swear I was like walking on the edge too, and it just, I don't know.
Should we go in?
Are you coming, Jess?
I'm still at my base trying to clean up my mess.
Okay.
There's
guess
the
we're going in.
Oh, I'm. What do you mean it's not loaded? Oh, I'm scared now.
Watch you guys. I'll watch your stream.
I don't see the Ender Dragon.
No, it's not loaded in, so.
Whoop! I just looked at that Enderman, though.
There you go. Sweet.
Yeah, I'm gonna put up. Oh, he can't break cobble either, can he? Oh, watch out, dude! Oh, snap!
Oh,
I think we just.
We need to kill this guy.
Hold on, let me make sure that we're not gonna fall off.
While we're here.
You guys, I think I'm just gonna hang glide off into the.
Do it, dude! Oh my god, I'm doing it. Do I have anything? No. Oh, I have diamond armor. Crap. I'll put it in
so
a chest.
Just
give it to me, and I'll bring it back.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Oh my god, I want to. Really bad.
Oh my god.
I'm doing it. Will you take my stuff?
Yeah. I'll just make a GIF, and it'll be the best GIF ever.
Here,
you're going to have to...
Hold on, let me put all your stuff in a bag.
You're going to have to walk all the way back to the end portal again, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, no, you give me a book.
Bad. How are you going to take the book beyond death?
But the book
is... Oh, crap.
The intro.
This sucks.
Yeah. Hold on, do you want a second... You want to give that a second thought?
No, I don't care. YOLO.
Oh, God.
I'm doing it. I'm doing it.
Someone asked, can you
don't
make
do it
cloud
yet.
Boots?
No, what? Oh, what?
Don't do it yet.
Why do you say that?
Don't slip. It's not worth it.
Let's test out the Enderman farm quick, and then we'll do it.
Oh. Well, this
yeah,
might...
it needs to be out further than
it
that.
It needs to be out way further.
Default animations.
I know.
YOLO!
Oh, that's there awesome. He goes! There he goes!
Slip! No, don't do it!
I'm going to see what this is.
He's up into nothingness.
What is it?
This is straight bedrock.
Is it
really?
That's
weird. Just random bedrock, huh?
Yeah. How high am I right now? Y2. It's almost over, guys.
Oh, no.
Don't do it, Slip.
Oh, I have ender pearls. Maybe I can pearl back up there.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
there you go. Try
it. Actually, wait. I think it's too far. Oh, I think it's way too far.
Try to go through through clouds.
Oh, no. I didn't think you could go below Y0.
Yeah, mm-hmm. You get like 10 blocks of free space and then you start taking damage or something.
I'm at Y30. Y-30.
Whoa.
Really?
Yeah.
You're not taking damage?
No.
Maybe because you're parachuting or whatever?
Oh, I've got water.
Oh, there it goes.
Don't egg or anything.
I was way low, though. Sick. So we had a great time hanging out. There's the valley and the houseboat over in that direction. There you can see the Ender Portal waypoint here. And if we hang glide over in this direction, we pass this rad island. I think I showed it off last episode. Also, this great chunk error, F3A. Can we do that while we're hang gliding? Is this going to be a thing? Oh, wow. F3A did not improve our ability to see. So, and I can't remember if I told you guys, when you hold shift, you go faster with the hang glider. Pretty cool, pretty cool. But right here in the water is where the Ender Portal is, down in here. And it really kind of remarkably close to the base. I mean, I think that I heard something today, like, oh, about 1,000 blocks apart. I don't know. Is that correct? Could be wrong. But, yeah, so you can go into here. Oh, no. Active dragon. Run! Why is there... Run! I am peacing out. Oh, God. So you can see it looks like the dragon took out some of the cobble that was back there. There's my death waypoint from when I died. Let's just clear out that guy. Where are you? Where are you, hotkey? No, that was wrong. Select, delete, delete, done. Back to game. Yeah, so we made a little ghetto area to do ender farming. Oh no. Go, Mojang. And really kind of funny because, oh, come on. Really kind of funny because at the level that we're at right now, this is really all you need. Like, just this little spawnable space here, it provides plenty of ender pearls, especially if you're using looting 3 like I am on Simon. So you can just grab some ender pearls like so. Mirage Enderman. Oh, yeah, they look like there's a bunch of them, but they're really only one. There's all sorts of weird Endermen. That guy is Thursgrab Flarb, the Marb Blarble or something. What is his name? Let's see if we can kill around him. I want to see what his actual name is. Thargrabslin Hell Sit Let to When. That's pretty crazy. Yeah, I'm assuming he's some sort of boss level guy. I don't know. He looks to have the same. Oh, he drops emeralds? Oh man! Gastier! Oh, so scary! So scary! Peace out. So there's a book here that takes you back to Hypno's base, and then right here at Hypno's base is a book that takes you there. So we don't really have to. Oh, wrong way. We don't really have to worry about getting over there with a hang glider or anything like that. But yeah, so. That's going to be it for today, guys. I hope that you liked the video. I am inside of cows now. If you did like the video, please don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to share and favorite the video as you see fit. I had fun hanging around, derping around with you guys today. Yeah, thanks so much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day. Cowbutt.